Welcome to Ground Control. It is
Thursday, April 9th.
I am Ms. Forthover.
And I'm Mrs. Nelson. And today is day 25 of our, whatever this is,
extended
breaks. I don't know. Enjoy.
Hello, Bay High School. This is Mr. Spellman. Just checking in with you for our sports fact of the day. Just have one for today, and that is in 1965, Major League Baseball held its first indoor baseball game between the New York Yankees and the Houston Astros in the famous Houston Astrodome. So this was back in 1965. I also want to remind student athletes, don't forget about our fitness challenge that we put together for all the respective teams. I'll be starting it out with my family, and then I'll be challenging a specific team. And that fitness challenge can be anything from riding a bike with family members, doing a relay race, doing a pickup basketball game or pickup soccer game in your yard while performing social distancing. So we're not encouraging teams to get together to do runs or to play games, but we're encouraging either family fun activities or individual activities that are centered around physical fitness. So be on the lookout for that. Again, this weekend I'll be coming out with my first challenge as a family, and I will be then challenging a specific team to go on for the next challenge. So be on the lookout for that sometime this weekend. Hope everyone has a great day, and go Rockets.
All right, well, let's see what the science department has to share with us these days.
Our science joke of the day: one day on Mercury lasts about 1,408 hours here on Earth, which is about the same as one Monday. But one day on Venus lasts 116 days and 18 hours on Earth, which is exactly equal to one day of quarantine. All right, our fun fact of the day also revolves around Venus, our closest neighbor. It has a largely volcanic surface and extremely thick and acidic atmosphere with a surface air pressure about 90 times that of what we have here on Earth. And so if you could land on the surface of Venus, you would be burned, poisoned, crushed, and suffocated all at once. So in case you were wondering, guys, there is something worse than quarantine. If you're looking for a book or movie recommendation, The Martian, fabulous book, great movie. I love Matt Damon, but the book is really, I think, much better because it does a great job of explaining the science. So the science is real, even though the story is fiction. But I will warn you, there's a bit of swearing involved. So I'd be swearing, too, if I were stranded alone on Mars. This guy managed to master the art of social distancing. So check it out. It's highly enjoyable.
Thanks for that. Let's go to the English department now.
Hi, everyone. It's Mr. Slanina again. It's April 9th, and here is your poem for today. Today, again, we're keeping it in Cleveland, Ohio with Cleveland Poets, so we are going to discuss Hart Crane. Hart Crane is an extremely famous poet who wrote in the early 1900s. He was born in Garrettsville, Ohio, which is right next to Aurora, Ohio, and his father, interestingly enough, invented the lifesaver candy. So Hart Crane kind of had a turbulent life. He didn't really like his home life. He didn't like his where he was, so he kind of moved to New York City like everyone does. Wants to go to a bigger city, thought life would be great there, and unfortunately he met with some difficulties and kind of moved back to Cleveland, back to New York, back to Cleveland for the rest of his life. The reason I bring up Hart Crane, though, is one of my favorite spots in Cleveland is Hart Crane Park. So those of you who have eaten at Merwin's Wharf, or if you row at the Foundry, right on Merwin, if you look next to the river, is Hart Crane Park. Go check it out if you haven't. It's on Merwin again, down in the flats, and you can watch the big freighters go by. It's right on the river, and it's a nice quiet place. So instead of reading a poem from Hart Crane, he wasn't really too uplifting of a poet. I think I'm going to read a poem from one of my poetry professors at John Carroll. James Magner wrote a poem about Hart Crane and some of the turbulent life that he lived, and his poem is titled Wondrous Mariner. Wondrous mariner, how your galleons of fire, vaulting blue, exceed me as amoeba to the sun. Dark angel of Myers Barr, who wove demise in shadowed rooms and phallic landfalls not of beach, but of morning's wounding reef and snapping shades of South Street, yet wondrous, now, is the weave we feel from Carib's stare, Orphic leaps from Brooklyn's heights, sensuous pariah, wraith of South, who has, after all, exceeded time in songs from a broken tower. So once again, that's a poem by James Magner about the poet Hart Crane. And if you want to, you can read about Hart Crane's turbulent life. If you just do a search of Hart Crane and Poetry Foundation, they have a great biography of him, some pictures, and you can learn why he even now speaks to poets today. So again, everyone, I hope you're having a great day, and I hope to see you soon.
Thanks for that. That was awesome. Now, let's check in with the best department, the History Department.
Today in history, something happened.
Hello, Bay High School. Let's look at what happened in today's day in history. On April 9th, 1865, General Robert E. Lee surrendered to Ulysses S. Grant at Appomattox Courthouse in Virginia.
Hi, this is Mrs. Meadows from the library. One of the things that I enjoy doing while walking my dog, gardening, or doing chores is listening to an audiobook. I'm going to show you how to download free audiobooks to your phone or device from the library. First, you're going to want to download either the Overdrive or the Libby app. Then you need a library card number. This is the library website, Cuyahoga County Public Library. And right here, they have a statement that says, no library card, no problem, get one now. And you would click on that link and follow the directions. They also have suggestions on other apps besides the two I've mentioned, and they will have directions on how to download these devices, these audiobooks, books, and other options to your phone or other device. If you have never listened to an audiobook, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone is available right now for everyone, and Harry Potter audiobooks are some of the best to try out. Here are some other examples that I found when I searched under teen audiobooks. So go ahead and give one a try.
All right, people, we hope you have a great day. That was a great show. Have a great rocket day.
Stay tuned for the wacky news.
Thank you. That was literally in.